In the last video, we saw some examples of how our genes are in mismatch with our current environment. We looked at examples of how our overconsumption and inactivity is driven by our old genes. But there are other domains, other lifestyles, that are very important for healthy aging that are also influenced by the mismatch. For example, in the way we sleep. When I was in Ghana, which is on the equator, it would always be dark at 6 p.m. Around 9, everybody was asleep. This makes sense because as soon as it's dark, the body starts to produce a hormone called melatonin. After a few hours, the levels of melatonin tell your body it's time to go to bed. You start to feel sleepy, you close your eyes, and you fall asleep. In our modern environment, as soon as it's dark, we turn on the light. This artificial light also contains blue light at a wavelength of 460 to 480 nanometers, which blocks the buildup of melatonin. The screens we watch in the evening also emit this wavelength and keep us awake. At 11 o'clock, after finishing some last work or watching some last episodes of our favorite television series, we close our laptops and go to bed to find our bodies not yet prepared for sleep. Large numbers of people have difficulty falling asleep, and many turn to their doctors for sleeping pills. A good night's sleep not only makes you feel energized and relaxed, research shows that it also helps healthy aging. Even a single night of disrupted sleep can cause metabolic changes. Your body develops a resistance to insulin, just as in type 2 diabetes. Luckily, this is reversible after a good night's sleep, but this testifies how important sleep is not only for the mind, but also for the body. Besides the way we sleep, the way we experience stress has also greatly changed. In the past, we would have been subject to periods of acute stress, a lion or a lot of danger, followed by periods of relaxation. In our current 24-hour economy, however, there's always work. There are always deadlines ahead. Our bodies have never adapted to deal with this chronic stress, and that is one of the reasons why so many people suffer from burnout. Social contacts are also very important in old age. Several studies have shown that people with small social networks, people that are lonely, have much higher mortality risks that can be up to 40% higher compared to people that are not lonely. In the past, we lived in small communities with a lot of related people. Your family would live close together and everybody knew each other. In our modern environment, we live in cities with millions together. But even though we live with so many people, it's common that people don't know the neighbors that live 100 meters further in the street. Loneliness is a big problem in old age and has a large impact on the quality of life. This was the last video of step one. In this first step, I've taken you to Ghana and back. We've looked at how we used to age in the past, and we've introduced the mismatch of our old genes and our modern environment as the fundamental cause of our unhealthy aging patterns, influencing our diet, our physical activity, but also sleep, stress levels, and social contacts. In the next step, step two, the medical reflex and the alternative, let us look at the current medical approach to some of the age-related diseases and symptoms that result from the mismatch.